Hello, welcome back. So now in this part, we will solve an example to see how we calculate the coordinate of the centroid. So there is a problem in this. It is asking determining the distance y bar. Y bar basically the coordinate of centroid, which will be measured from the x-axis to the centroid of the area of the triangle. So there is a triangle. And of the triangle, we have to find out the y bar coordinate of the CG. Say this is the triangle, and in this triangle, our first step is to choose the finite strip, which will be having differential thickness. So because now this triangle will be having centroid, say it will be located somewhere here, and it will be having coordinate with reference to y axis as x bar and with reference to x axis as y bar. So in the question, we are asked to find out the y bar value only. So to calculate the y bar value, our first step is to choose the strip. So we have chosen a horizontal strip, which is cutting at this point, and the coordinate at this point is x and y. Now, this strip is having length x and it is located at a height of y with reference to x-axis. So that is what we have done in this triangle. So we have this triangle and we have to find out y bar of this triangle. So in that, what we have done is we have choose a strip. It will be basically a rectangular strip, which will be having a differential thickness as dy and this dimension as x. So this strip will be cutting at this line at a coordinate x and y. Okay, so that is the case. So in the solution, our first step is basically the differential element. So we have now chosen the differential element. So here we have written here this as, consider a rectangular element having a thickness dy and it is located in an arbitrary position so that it intersects the boundary at xy here. Then our next step is to find out, okay, first of all, we will also need to find out the equation of this straight line. So we can find out this equation of straight line that as y is equal to f of x. So what is this f of x? For that, So this is y is equal to f of x. So function of x basically. So in that case, we have to define what is the value of y. So we have to find out the equation of this line. So for getting the equation of this line, what we can do is we can make this triangle from this triangle. And the height of this triangle is y. And this distance is, we can write this as b minus x because the remaining dimension, this is actually the x. So this is b minus x, this is y. Okay, so you can see this triangle is a similar triangle to the whole triangle. So what we can do is we can write the ratio b by h as y by b minus x. So ultimately y is equals to b by h b minus x. So that becomes the, so this is the f of x. So the equation for this line becomes y is equals to b by h b minus x. So that becomes the equation that we can make. So now the same is shown here. Okay, so now our next step is to find out the area and moment of arms, which means x approx and y approx. So we are required to find out y bar only, so there is no need to find out x approx. So first of all, we will find out the area of the differential element. So this differential element is basically the strip. which is having a length x and which is having thickness dy. So the area dA will be x into dy. So this x can be calculated using this equation. So in this equation, solving this for the x, we can get x is equals to b by h and h minus y. So that we can solve in terms of x. So that becomes our x into dy. So what we are doing is we are actually determining the dA value in terms of the equation of this line that we have calculated earlier. Then we will find out the value of arms, this one, these x approx and y approx. So x approx is equals to x, this one, sorry. In this, basically x approx and y approx is the coordinates of the centroid of this finite element. So in this case, x approx will be equals to, I mean, you can see here, this is the CG of, centroid of this element. So the distance will be x by 2. So x approx becomes x by 2. Similarly, y approx will be now distance of this with reference to x-axis. So this is equals to y. So y approx is y. So because we have to find out y bar, so our main concerning value will be this one. Now our next step is to do the integration. So using the equation 5, we will be integrating with respect to y. Why? Because we are required to find out y bar. So in that we have this equation. So in this, we have this integration y approx multiplied by dA. So we already know the value of dA. We already know the value of y approx, which will be y into, and the value of dA will be this is b by h multiplied by h minus y. So this y is this one, and this dA is this value that we have calculated earlier. Similarly, upon integrating the whole dA, so that becomes b by h minus a. So that is the value of dA. Now the limit, as the differential thickness is along the y-axis, so therefore the dimension along the y-axis is h. So starting from 0 to h, because our y-bar value will be along the h value, so therefore that is the limit, 0 to h. So solving this, if we try to solve this value, so we can find out this as 0 to h, and this becomes our by minus by q by h into dy. Similarly, solving the lower equation, so this becomes 0 h, and this is b minus by upon h. Now integrating this equation, we get, I'm writing here, then we get by square by 2 minus, sorry, this was square actually, and this becomes by cube by 3, and the limit is h 0. Now solving this, we get, I am now writing here, BH square by 2 minus BH cube by 3. Sorry, here there will be H also because this H will be here. So 3H. So H will cut 1H. So that becomes BH square by 2 minus BH square by 3. So that becomes one by six BH square. So that is the value of this integration. Similarly, solving this one, so we will get this as now I'm writing the value here. This will be BY minus BY square by 2H. And the limit is H 0. Now solving this, we get BH minus BH square by 2H. And H to H, it will be canceled out. And then we will be having half BH. So this one is half BH and this term is 1 by 6 BH square. Now, which means 1 by 6. So now I am writing here 1 by 6 BH square by 1 by 2 BH. So ultimately we get H by 3. So y bar is equals to h by 3, which means the CG, centroid of this triangle will be h by 3 from the x-axis. So that is the answer. So the same I have written here. So that becomes the value of y bar. So this value h by 3, it will be valid for other triangles also. Like that, the result is valid for any shape of triangle. It states that centroid is located at 1/3 the height measured from the base of the triangle. So it proves that the centroid of the triangle will be at h by 3 distance with reference to x-axis. Similarly, with reference to y-axis, it will be h by 3 and this will be b by 3. So that becomes the equation. So that is the solution. Now in the next part, we will solve another example. Thank you.